There had been a number of requests to include some kind of guitar stuff in the album, so there it is. But there's going to be another guitar box coming out next year, another three-record box. So that'll be all guitar.
Thank you. think we did about 120 shows, if I counted that right, something like that. It got pretty nice results out of it at some point. And I improved that camera already. The thing with the double lens was that with the regular lens on, whatever lens you might have on there, you're really limited and you operate only that parameter that that lens offers you. And with the semi-fisheye, super wide angle, you pop that on and you sort of create a second camera image, especially because with that lens you don't have to focus, you just leave it all open, and you get these kind of semi-distorted angles, which, well, you know, music video lends itself, if you don't overdo it, of course.
Not too bad, okay, that's cool, how about that? Next one. Zappa one, maybe?
I think, you know, for whatever I do, I always want to be, you know, full on, or try to be, you know, really get into it. And it's like obsession, I think, is one word for it. You might want to apply it. And otherwise, you know, it's like just vegetating. That's. I mean, I when I sleep, let's say, all day, I get like almost depressed and think, God, well, what could I have done? Or what, you know, then again, you got to sleep too, you know. But to wake up to the woodpecker.
No more.
I don't understand you. Could you speak more clearly?
If you don't like,
where'd you get that word?
What you have got?
Appropriate.
Drop it in the dirt.
Drop it, yeah.
And let it rot.
I can smell it now.
Someone else.
Kitty come.
Will surely come.
I told you he was coming.
And pick it up.
Yeah, right.
Cause he wants some.
And he'll want it for free.
And when one day.
I wonder
who you used to was,
who I was anyway,
and what you do.
Well, we really need a hit single. Just think, I mean, the way the world's going today, with all the problems in it, I bet I could actually change the world. Because it's the young people that really need to be changed. And you could really do that through music and everything. This was our last hit single. It was really a bummer. They wouldn't even play it on the radio. Oh well, gotta come up with something better than that. coming to the beginning of a new era wherein the development of the inner self
will be our most important asset.
Will be our most important asset.
Do it again.
We're coming to the beginning of a new era wherein the development of our inner self will be the most important asset.
And improvising to music like this is part of that development. Now, if I take this sock and put it over here, I'll put it right there, that. Now that's commercial. But if I take the sock and put it here, now that's underground. We want something commercial because we want a hit single on the radio.
Country and Western.
Yeah, country and Western probably. That's what the kids are really digging today. So I think that the single should be this. I think we're going to need a new bird. Or maybe another bird. Where can we get a bird?
Maybe on the road.
On the road. I'm sure we could find one on the road. If you've ever been on the road, you know what I mean.
You found that bird on the road, somebody ran over it.
How's that for an intro?
Great, I like that sax note at the end.
Yeah. Because you do some pretty wild intros yourself on stage,
don't
you?
Oh, yeah, and some outros, too.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
What's the wildest sort of entrance you've ever done on a stage? Well, you told me you slid down a wire thing once or something.
No, that's not true.
It's not?
No. Oh. In fact, many of the things you might have heard about me in the program are probably not true.
Yeah. What is your program about, or would you rather not talk about it?
I could demonstrate some of the things that we do, you know, in theory. I could demonstrate it with what you have here, if you like me to?
Yeah, if you could, yeah, I would.
Okay. Sometimes during our show, we'll conduct the audience as a musical instrument. As like, I have hand signals that I use to conduct the band that gives them cues to make musical sound effects and so forth. And sometimes these cues are extended to the audience if we have an audience that's in the mood for it. And looks like you guys might be in the mood for it, some of you anyway. What I'll do is demonstrate, first of all, what the cues are, and then I'll show you how they are to be applied to make a piece of music out of absolutely nothing. Okay? First of all, one finger means get ready to applaud. Now, ordinarily in TV, you've got a sign that lights up and says clap your hands. However, for this exercise, one finger means get ready to applaud. And I'll point to one part of the audience, and you start applauding over here. And as my finger goes across, you stop clapping, and the people over here start clapping, so you can move the applause around the room like stereo. It sounds very interesting, and you can also get the loudness and softness of the applause, and it'll work pretty nice. Let's try it. This means get ready. Start right over here on this side. The people in the front row will start clapping and stop as my hand goes across like that. Let's try it. As the hand goes across, you stop so that the sound travels over there. You have mono TV, folks, so you can't really hear it. But, okay, try it again. See, you're up at the top row now.
At the top.
That's the most simplistic one. Now the next is two fingers, and this requires that you make a very low noise. You can go... any low noise that you want to make with your mouth on cue for two fingers like this. Are you ready? Everybody at once. All right. Now, you guys wait for just a second. Now, if the band will watch, two fingers down like this means to play any low note on your instrument just as sort of a bump cutoff, you know, like an exclamation point. So the drummer would probably hit the kick drum, the floor tom, and the guitar player can play a low E, and you can hit your low E, and everybody else play a pedal tone and just a little toot like that. Try it one time. But really short and solid. Okay, now here is just the opposite of that. The highest possible note on your instrument. Just go. Okay. Now, we have four possible signals. Grunt, peep, clap, and poot. Okay? That's your odds. Okay? Now let's try and make something out of grunt, peep, clap, and poot. Okay? We'll start with a peep. We're going to enrich our musical texture now by including a chord, which you may choose, any note of your, any one you like, folks. Attack any pitch and increase the volume. This is an increase in volume, and this is bend the pitch down, and this is bend the pitch up. So, any note. Let the pitch fall off and just move it like that so that it's like a wave. One more time now.
That's wild.
Thank you. Salton House, and I'm working with Frank Zappa on his film Uncle Me in Hollywood. I'm a little nervous doing this because it's the first time I've ever been a star in a film. I originally started working for Frank as his assistant editor on the film Uncle Me. And one day I was sitting around watching the festival hall shots, the rushes, and I saw Don come on the screen, Don Preston, who plays the monster. And I said, Frank, look at Don. He's turning into a monster. I'm going to vomit.
When she sees him turn into a monster, she has to vomit.
Frank said, that's it. That's the opening of the line. That's the opening of the picture. I said, Frank, I can't be in your picture. First of all, I have such a bad Brooklyn accent. I'm embarrassed about the whole thing. And he said, don't worry, you'll do it. So, you know, with Frank, he has a certain way about him, and he just gets people to do these things.
He just makes me sick when he changes into a monster.
Why? Why does he make you sick?
Oh, can't you see it, how ugly it is, being that monster? Oh, just, I can't stand it. I think I'm going to be sick. I have to vomit.
So I figured, okay, I have nothing to lose, right? Well, first day of shooting came around, I was a nervous wreck. You see, what I wanted to say was, originally, how I came to know Frank and everything. You see, I worked for MGM Records. I think it was 1967. I worked for Tom Wilson. You remember he was going to run for president? Well, Tom was producing Frank's albums, The Mothers of Invention, and I started getting to know the mothers and thought that they were funny. One summer I spent practically every night at the Garrick Theater. I lived there in the West Village at the time, and I used to come by and drop in, and one night Frank even got me on stage, and I felt like a real jerk, but it was okay. You know, I saw he had this power to do this thing.
Eat your green. Don't forget your beans.
That's right.
This thing is, this is the brains of our PA system from the Garrick Theater, where we used to work in New York in 67. The whole band ran through this box and a couple of speaker columns. I didn't even know we still had this thing.
I don't know, what's this movie happening anyway, man? Is there a movie, man? Wow, shit, man, I figured out long ago that the tape recorder and the movie's always on. You know?
Now.
Well, it's always on, man. I mean, you know, you're just talking that, man.
Yeah, well, anyway, this is fantasy time for me. I'm gonna have a fantasy in my life right now. I'm gonna actually fulfill my fantasy, one of my sexual fantasies that they tell me I do have, which I never thought I had was, blowing. This is the way I think a girl should do it to me. It looks right, a little small for me, but you know. Whoa! I almost dropped my weenie there. Okay, now. I hate to get one with. I never like to touch it, you know. And then, well, all right, here we go. Oh, it even got a. It's been, you know, sanctified, circumcised, whatever that word is. As you see the little hole, which I didn't even notice. There is a little hole there, folks. You see? The little hole?
The word is circumcised.
It's circumcised. See? Believe me, I know. I told you I spell good. Okay? Now, this is the way I'd like it done to me. Okay? This is, all you girls out there, and this is the way I want you to do it. You slowly take your head, right? And just very slowly, you tease me with it. In other words, you just move your head around at first. See, like this. This is your head, and this is my thing. Okay? We call it a thing because there's no better name for it, but the thing. And you put your head around it, teasing me, with the aura of your mouth being near it. And then you slowly take your mouth, right? Slowly. And make all kinds of sort of sucking kind of looks to you, like... And then you take your tongue, doesn't matter which side of it, you just give it a quick grazing, you know? Right. Then you turn me on and I get all excited and hard and stuff. And then that's when you do it again. You go, take another lick, right? You get a little taste of what you're gonna soon slowly have for dessert. Now, as you slowly put your mouth upon it, you sort of suck as if it's a lollipop. You go. Yeah, I almost swallowed that. I'm not good at deep throat. And you get the savoring taste of it. Well, good. Then you roll it in your teeth, sort of brush your teeth with it. Go up and down in the front. And then you go to the side. And then you suck. Yeah, oh shit, I hate it. Well, girls, one thing, never, don't chew it, you know. Don't take a bite out of it like I just did. Because the guy is very mad.
Oh, oh,
very sick people. Very sick. Very sick. Stirring up that shit again, man. That dangerous shit, man. Mr. Zappa's gonna stir up the dog shit one more time. Just to see how foul it gets.
Thank you. Well, thank you. You're really too kind.
It is my personal feeling that lyrics will not harm you. There is no sound that you can make with your mouth or word that will come out of your mouth that is so powerful that it'll make you go to hell. It's not going to do it. It's also not going to turn you into a social liability. Disturbed people can be set off on a disturbed course of action by any kind of stimulus. If they are prone to being antisocial or schizophrenic or whatever, they can be set off by anything, including my tie or your hair or that chair over there or anything. Anything can set it off. You can't point to statistics of people doing strange things in the vicinity of rock music, because all you got to do is look around at all the normal kids who listen to it and live with it every day, who do not commit suicide, they don't commit murder, and they grew up to be, in some cases, legislators.
This is probably the worst type of child abuse we've got in this state, because it hits all the children. This is mass child abuse, and that's what it is. When they throw some of this slime at these children, it's abuse.
To say that rock music is the worst form of child abuse and that it's mass child abuse, I would call that sky-high rhetoric.
We're not talking about references to sex. We're talking about references to incest. Incest, and it says, do it, kids, it's fine. We're talking about rape and sexual violence. It's illegal in this state, but these records get out there and they say, do it, kids, it feels good. It's fine, it's okay. You gotta read this stuff to know just how dirty it is.
You guys read this? Would you read the synopsis?
This is pornography.
This is censorship. All right, I'll have to talk louder. I oppose this bill for a number of reasons. First of all, there's no need for it. The idea that the lyrics to a song are going to cause antisocial behavior as an exclusive cause of antisocial behavior, I think, is not supportable by science.
This bill is constitutional. We're talking about minors in the first place, and stop worrying about their civil rights. Start worrying about their mental health and about the health of our society.
In the part where it talks about it says, in this section, the following words have the meanings indicated. The bill seeks to keep you from seeing, renting, buying, or listening to material described as depicting illicit sex. And the description of what illicit sex, as per this bill, here's the description. Human genitals in a state of sexual stimulation or arousal. Is that illicit sex? Perhaps in Maryland. Acts of human masturbation, not animal masturbation. This is talking about human masturbation. You can't see that, but any other kind, I suppose you could see. Mechanical masturbation, perhaps. Or acts of government. Sexual intercourse or sodomy. Why do they indicate that sexual intercourse is illicit sex and put it next to sodomy in the same line? The next line, fondling or other erotic touching of human genitals. That is illicit in the state of Maryland, according to the law as already written?
The thing is, they know what they've got, they know what they're selling, and that's what they're trying to sell, because that's the only thing they could sell to these minors.
And then three, nude or partially denuded figures means less than completely and opaquely covered human genitals, pubic region, buttocks, or female breast below a point immediately above the top of the areola. Now, I like nipples. I think they look good. And if you are going to look at a woman's breast, if you take the nipple off, which is the characterizing determining factor, what you got is a blob of fat there. Okay? And I think that when you're a baby, probably one of the first things that you get interested in is that nozzle right there. And you get to have it right up in front of your face.
okay? You grow up with it, so to speak. And then you grow up to live in the state of Maryland, and they won't let you see the little brown thing anymore.
I'm not against artistic creativity. I'm not for censorship. I think adults have the right to listen to and see whatever they want. But we're talking about children here. This is to protect children.
Some people, when they start talking about pornography and saving the children and the rest of this stuff, in the desire to help a child, sometimes choose some strange ways to express it. And what I know about this bill basically is what I see on this paper and things that I've read in clippings sent to me from Baltimore papers. And some of the statements made in support of the bill, for example, I hope I'm not incorrectly quoting you, Delegate Toth, in the reference to rock music being the major cause of incest in the home. Did you say that? I'm sorry if I'm misquoting you. Somebody reported to me that you had said that, and I've, you know, been baffled by it ever since. But if you had said it, you know, well, I won't even bother to answer it since you didn't say it, but is it true that someone has said, I believe it was Delegate Owens, that rock music is the worst form of child abuse? The mass child abuse? I think you have problems in the law as it already exists, let alone amending it to include audio references to the things that are already in this document. Then, because it talks about not being able to advertise matter containing these objectionable topics, it opens up the possibility for this. A person wearing a Motley Crue t-shirt, if Motley Crue was adjudged by whatever forum is going to make these decisions to be a pornographic act, if the person is wearing the t-shirt, theoretically he could be fined $1,000 or go to jail for a year for his wardrobe. And if he wore it twice, it's $5,000 or imprisonment not to exceed 3 years or both unless otherwise provided.
More an example of censorship. Okay, the censorship doesn't always work like a guy takes a pencil and crosses or a black marker and takes a line out of a book or forces a record off the shelves. It doesn't always work that way. Here's a good example that is localized. I offered the Peabody Conservatory my services to teach for a couple of weeks. Okay? They wouldn't bring me in to do it, because they were afraid that they would lose their funding from the state, because the people that supported the censorship bill that was going on before, they were afraid that those same forces would remove funding from the entire Peabody Conservatory if I were brought there to teach.